Hello friends, now we'll discuss some questions which came in 2018 prelims examination which was conducted today on June 3rd, 2018. The questions which we'll be covering is from Indian polity, economy and current affairs. The first question, in the first Lok Sabha, the single largest party in the opposition was Swatantra Party. This is a wrong statement. In the fourth Lok Sabha, the single largest party in the opposition was Swatantra Party. Swatantra Party was formed by Dr. Rajaji in 1959. In Lok Sabha, a leader of opposition was recognized for the first time in 1969. This is the right statement. Ram Subhas Singh of Indian National Congress was recognized as LOP for the first time in 1969. A statutory status for LOP was given by a parliamentary act in 1977. For becoming LOP, the party should have 10% of the total MPs. So this is a wrong statement. 10% is the criteria. 10% of the total strength of the house, the party should have to become the LOP. So the answer is 2 only. The first statement is wrong. Third statement is wrong. Answer is 2 only. Third question. As per NSSO 70th round situation assessment survey of agricultural households, consider the following statement. Rajasthan had the highest percentage share of agricultural households among its rural households. Is a right statement. 78% is the share. Out of total agricultural households in the country, little over 60% belong to OBC. This is a wrong statement. 45% is the answer. In Kerala, 61% of agricultural households reported to have received maximum income from sources other than agricultural activity is a right statement. So the answer for third question is C, 1 and 3 only. Fifth question, Parliament of India can place a particular law in the 9th schedule of the Constitution is a right statement. First Amendment Act was inserting 31B, which was inserting a new schedule, 9th schedule. The validity of the law placed in 9th schedule cannot be examined by any court. So actually, Supreme Court in a landmark judgment in 2007 says that those laws and regulations kept under 9th schedule before 24th April 1973, that is the date of judgment of Kesavananda Bharathi case, they will be having judicial immunity, but those laws which are kept on or after this particular date will be coming under judicial review. So the second statement is wrong statement based on Supreme Court judgment in 2007. So the answer is 1 only. Sixth question is on merchant discount rate. The answer is the charge to a merchant by a bank for accepting payment from his customers through the bank's debit cards. Actually, this charge will be split amongst three people. One, who lends the POS terminal, and secondly, who has issued a bank which has issued the debit card, and thirdly, one who provided the payment gateway. So C is the right answer for sixth question. Seventh question, consequences of a country becoming the member of NSG. India seeks to become a member of NSG because definitely by becoming a member of NSG, we will be able to access the latest and the sophisticated technology. But this is a wrong statement. By becoming a member of NSG, we are not going to become a member of NPT. It is not automatic inclusion into NPT upon becoming a member of NSG. So the answer is A, 1 only. Eighth question is on equalization tax. It was introduced in India in 2016. It came into force from June 1st, 2016. It was basically because of the OECD recommendation under its BEPS plan that there should be a tax imposed on the digital goods and services by the e-commerce firms. So it was not introduced as a part of the Income Tax Act. It was introduced under Chapter 8 of the Finance Bill 2016. And since it is not calculated as a tax, income tax, it will not be eligible under double taxation avoidance agreement. So the both the statements are wrong statements. So the answer is D, neither one nor two. The next question is, FRBM review committee has recommended a debt GDP ratio of 60% for the general government by 2023, comprising 40% for central government and 20% for the state government is a right statement. The second statement is a wrong statement because the central government liability, domestic liability is 49% and the state liability is 21%. So it is a wrong statement. 49% is for central government liability, 21% is state government liability. So this statement is a wrong statement because the facts are wrongly given. This is a wrong statement. As per the Constitution of India, it is mandatory for the state to take central government's consent for raising any loan, and this is a right statement under Article 293. This statement is a right statement. Hence, the answer is 1 and 3 only. Next question is, the quantity of imported edible oil is more than the domestic production of the edible oil in the last 5 years. Yes, this is the right statement. More than double the amount of domestic production is the quantity of the imported oil for the last 4 years especially. So this is the right statement. We are importing more edible oil than the domestic production is the right statement. The government does not impose any customs duty on all the imported edible oil as a special case. So this we have not seen. So this is a wrong statement. The government does not impose any customs duty on all imported edible oil as a special case is a wrong statement. So the answer is A1 only. 12th question, Aadhaar card cannot be used as a proof of citizenship or domicile, neither it is granting any right to citizenship, nor it is a proof of citizenship according to the Kolkata High Court. So the first statement is a wrong statement. Once issued, Aadhaar card can be deactivated. Sections 27 and 28 of the Aadhaar Regulation 2016 says that if more than one Aadhaar card is given to the same person, or if the biometric data is not matching, then definitely Aadhaar card can be deactivated. So both the statements are wrong statement. Answer is neither one nor two. 15th question, which one of the following links all the ATMs in India? The answer is National Payment Corporation of India. Consider the following statement. 16th question, capital adequacy ratio is the amount that the banks have to maintain in the form of their own funds to offset any loss that banks incur if the account holders fail to repay the due is a right statement. CAR is not decided by the individual bank, it is decided by the central bank, that is the Reserve Bank of India. So the second statement is a wrong statement. Answer is A1 only. Next question, 17th question, application program interfaces, APIs, what does this imply? It can be integrated into any electronic device is a right statement. Online authentication using iris is possible is also a right statement. Both the statements are correct statement. So the answer is C, both 1 and 2. 20th question, with respect to Parliament of India, which parliamentary committee scrutinizes and reports to the House whether the powers to make regulation, rules, sublaws, bylaws, etc. conferred by constitution? The answer is Committee on Subordinate Legislation, which is having 15 members nominated by the speaker. Every member will serve for 1 year term. Ministers cannot be appointed as member of this parliamentary committee. 21st question, Right to Education Act, eligibility for appointment as a teacher in the state. The qualification is laid not by the state council but by the national council. So this is a wrong statement. As per the RTE Act, primary classes teachers will have to pass the teacher's eligibility test is a right statement. In India, more than 90% of the educational teacher education institutions are under the private, not under the state government. So the answer is B2 only. Next question, the Food Safety and Standards Act 2006 replaced the Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954 is a right statement. The Food Safety Standard Authority is under the charge of a chairperson, not under the charge of the Director General of Health Service. He is a repository of the technical knowledge related to public health, medical education, etc. So this is under the chairperson, and hence the answer is A1 only. Next question, 25th question, National Food Security Act 2013. Families coming under the BPL category are eligible. Not BPL category, the beneficiaries will be identified according to the socio-economic caste census by the respective state government. The eldest women in the household age 18 years or above shall be the head of the household for the purpose of issuance of a ration card is a right statement. Pregnant mother and lactating mothers will be getting 6,000 rupees. Only the children's aged 6 months to 14 years will get a take-home ration, not the pregnant women and lactating mother. Only the children aged 6 months to 14 years will have the entitlement to take home ration. So this is a wrong statement. Answer is B2 only. 28th question, BIM app allows the user to transfer money to anyone with a UPI-enabled bank account is a right statement. While chip-in debit card has 2 factors of authentication, BIM app has 3 factors of authentication. So this is a wrong statement. Hence answer is 1 only. Next question, ILO convention was ratified by India, convention number 138 and 182. It is related to child labor. So 30, answer is child labor. 31st, regarding money bill, which among the following statement is not correct? Actually, C statement is not correct because money bill is concerned with the appropriation of money out of the consolidated fund of India, not out of the contingency fund of India. Wrong statement is asked. C is the wrong statement. Other statements are right statement. So the answer for 31 is C. 32nd, election of the president of India. The value of the vote of each MLA varies from state to state. Yes, big population state will have the MLAs whose value will be more than the MLAs coming from the small populated states. For example, a Sikkim MLA vote will be less than that of the MLA vote coming from the UP. The value of Lok Sabha MP and Raj Sabha MP will be same. They are not different. So the second statement is a wrong statement. Hence answer is A, one only. 33, additional protocol with IAEA means the civilian nuclear reactors will come under the ambit of IAEA safeguards, whereas the military nuclear reactor will be outside the scrutiny of IAEA. So A is the right answer for 33rd question. Free trade partners of ASEAN, Australia is there, New Zealand is there, Republic of Korea is there, China is there, India is there, Japan is there. So who is not there? Canada is not there, US is not there. So the answer is 1, 3, 4 and 5. C is the right answer for 34th question. Digital India plan of government of India, formation of India's own internet companies like China did. This is not the aim. Establish a policy framework to encourage overseas multinational corporations that collect the big data to build their own data centers. This is also a wrong statement, and this is the right statement. Connecting many of our villages to the internet and bring Wi-Fi to many of our schools, public places and major tourist center. So the answer is B, 3 only for 36th question. Next, 39th question. The Speaker of the Legislative Assembly shall vacate his office if he ceases to be a member of the Assembly is a right statement. But when the Assembly is dissolved, he need not vacate immediately. So this is a wrong statement under Article 179. So answer is 1 only. Hope says that the relation between law and liberty is that if there are no law, then there is no freedom, there is no liberty. This is a statement made by John Locke in 17th century. So B is the right answer for 40th question. 41. No criminal proceeding shall be instituted against the governor of the state during his term of office. Yes, under Article 361, this is a right statement. The emoluments and the allowances of the governor shall not be diminished during his term of office is also a right statement. So the answer for this question is C, both 1 and 2. Under Article 158, statement 2 is right. Under Article 361, statement 1 is right. So the answer is both 1 and 2 are right statements. Next question, rule of law. Rule of law includes definitely limitation of the power of the government. Equality before law is present. People should be responsible to the government because they should not violate the law of the land. And definitely, if you follow rule of law, the rights and liberties of the people will be protected. Hence, all the four statements will be right. Answer is 1, 2, 3 and 4. 46. Legal tender means what? Legal tender money means a money which a creditor is under compulsion to accept in settlement of his claim. So B is the right answer for 46th question, legal tender money. If a commodity is provided free to public by the government, then definitely the opportunity cost is transferred from the consumers of the product to the tax paying public. What do you mean by opportunity cost? If we choose an alternative, we are missing another alternative. So what is the gain for which we are losing something? So opportunity cost is we are losing something to gain something. If the government is giving free of cost some commodities which is not free, then definitely it will be an expense to the public. So the government will tax the public in order to pay for the commodity which the government is giving free of cost to the public. There are free goods which are available in nature. For example, air is a free good, water is a free good, for which there is no opportunity cost at all. But when it comes to the economic goods, definitely there is an opportunity cost, and this opportunity cost will be transferred to the public. And that is the right answer for 47th question. 48th question is a simple question which is asking you the basic distinction between growth and development. Growth means prosperity, but development is equitable distribution of the growth. So There may be growth, but there is an unequal distribution of wealth, and this may result in what? Poverty and unemployment increase. So the answer for this question is, even though GNP may increase, but this is not going to lead to economic development because there may be present unequal distribution of the income coming from growth. Without distribution of the income, it will lead to only poverty, it will lead to only unemployment. So the answer for 48th question is C. 49th question, human capital. Economists have told that a country which is scarce in material capital will have to invest in human capital. Human capital means more knowledge, skill, all these things comes under human capital. So human capital is best explained by increasing the knowledge, skill levels and capacities of the people, and intangible wealth. Tangible wealth is material capital, intangible wealth is human capital. Knowledge, skill, these are coming under human capital. So the country which is scarce in material capital will have to invest on human capital. So the answer for 49th question is C, 2 and 4. 50. Despite being a high saving economy, capital formation may not result in significant increase in output because it may be because of high capital output ratio. For per unit of a product, we may have to invest more units of capital. This is what is high capital output ratio. High capital output ratio is not desirable, whereas low capital output ratio is desirable, that for more output, more units of output, you need to spend less investment, you need to make less investment. So high capital output ratio is undesirable, low capital output ratio is desirable, and the answer for 50th question is high capital output ratio. D is the right answer. If the President of India exercises power as provided under Article 356, what will happen? The power of the legislature of the state shall be exercisable by or under the authority of the parliament. So this is the right answer for 53rd question, and this is given in Article 356. Reserve Bank of India manages and services Government of India security but not the state government security. Definitely RBI will also service the state government security, not should not come. Treasury bills are issued by the Government of India and not by the state government. This is the right statement. Treasury bills are often issued at a discount from the par value. This is a right statement. So answer is 2 and 3 only. 56th question, answer is C. 58th question, the term WannaCry, Petya, Eternal Blue is mentioned in the news recently. They are related to cyber attacks. 58, cyber attack is the right answer. 67, solar power production in India. India is third largest. This is a wrong statement. Solar power tariff is determined by Solar Energy Corporation of India is a right statement. So the answer for this 67th question is B, 2 only. 78th question, PM Kaushal Vikas Yojana is a flagship scheme of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So this is a wrong statement. It is under the Skill Development Ministry, not under the Ministry of Labour and Employment. Among other things, it will impart training on soft skills, entrepreneurship, financial and digital literacy is a right statement. It aims to align the competencies of the unregulated workforce of the country to the national skill qualification framework. This is also a right statement. So the answer is 1 is wrong, 2 and 3 is right. Answer is C for 78th question. PAGE, Partnership for Action on Green Economy, was a product of Rio Plus 20. 2012, Rio Plus 20. PAGE is a product of Rio Plus 20 in 2012, which was held in Rio de Janeiro. So the answer for 83 is B. Right to privacy is protected as an intrinsic part of right to life and personal liberty. We very well know that this right to life and personal liberty comes under Article 21 of Part 3 of the Constitution. So C is the right answer for 92. 93rd question. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has announced the MSP for which of the above? 1 should not come, 3 should not come, 7 should not come. So the answer for 93rd question is B, 2, 4, 5 and 6. 93rd question, B is the right answer. 96th question, governance of public sector banking in India. Capital infusion into the public sector banks by the Government of India has steadily increased in the last decade. Is the statement steadily increased is wrong. Why? Because 2013-14 capital infusion was 14,000 crore. But in 2014-15, capital infusion became less than 7,000 crore, 6,990 crore. So it did not increase steadily. So this is a wrong statement because of the term steadily increased. To put the public sector banks in order, the merger of associate banks with the parent State Bank of India has been affected. From April 1, 2017, there are 6 banks which got merged with the State Bank of India, 5 associate banks of State Bank of India, and the one Mahila Bank, Bharatiya Mahila Bank. Because of the merger of the 6 banks, associate banks, the customer base of SBI will become 36 crore and the deposit base will become 26 lakh crore. So this is a right statement that to put the public sector banks in order, merger of associate banks with the parent State Bank of India has been affected. Is a right statement. Answer is B2 only. 97. Which among the above items were exempted under GST? Cereal grains hulled is there. Chicken eggs cooked, whether raw or cooked, it is there. Processed fish or canned fish is not there. So, 3 should not come. And newspapers containing advertising material is present. So, 3 should not come. Without 3, the answer is C. 1, 2 and 4 only for 97. 100th question. National Program for Organic Protection is operated under the guidelines and directions of not the Rural Development Ministry but the Commerce Ministry. So, the first statement is wrong. Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority functions as a secretariat for the implementation of NPOP is a right statement. And third statement is also a right statement. Sikkim has become India's first fully organic state. So, the answer is B, 2 and 3 only. Thank you friends for watching this video on question discussion Prelims 2018 held on June 3rd, 2018. Thank you.